Well, hello, hello. I hope all is well. Weather over here in the Netherlands is absolutely horrible, so bear with me when it comes to the natural light, but that's not why we're here. So today I am gonna talk all about the As I Am leave-in conditioners. I have to say, I think that I have 90% of their whole collection of leave-ins, and I really want to talk you through into picking the right leave-in conditioner or moisturizer for your hair that is suitable for your hair type and hair needs. So if you are wondering which of these are the best fit for you, then most definitely keep on watching. As I Am has multiple ranges, and their main line, their main range, has most variety when it comes to moisture or leave-in conditioners. That is the line that we're gonna start off with, and then I'm going to discuss the lines that entered over the years and what the difference is between those leave-in conditioners in comparison to the ones that they have in their main range. Okay, so I'm gonna start off with the simplest out of them all, and that is the Coco Shea Spray. Now, this is kind of like a hydrating spray. It is very lightweight, it is liquidy, and the main ingredients are water, coconut oil, glycerin, and shea butter. And that is exactly what you feel. It kind of has a milky consistency, as you can see, but it is still very lightweight. Scent wise, you either hate it or love it. It's kind of a natural scent. It's not that spectacular, but I would suggest to use this as a daily mist to re-moisturize your hair, or if you have a very thin hair or a looser texture, like if you're in the two ranges, maybe you can pull it off if you're in three, but I doubt it, as your main leave-in. But it's definitely nice to use this kind of as a moisture or hydration boost for your hair in between your washes. Another one out of their main range is literally what it says, their leave-in conditioner. I am a big fan of this one, but I do have to say that this one, it is a little bit thicker, but still liquidy, if that makes any sense. This one is formulated more with powders. So for example, coconut fruit powder and different extracts. And I feel like that is the biggest reason why this one just doesn't match with a lot of other products. I've really noticed more flaking when I combine this one with other brands or other styling agents, even in their range. So this one isn't that easy to use in combination. This is the consistency. So it's very kind of a gel-like texture. So you would actually think that this would be a great match to mix, but this one, it just doesn't mix well. So that is something that you do need to keep in mind. When it comes to hair types that it's suitable for, I would say every hair type, it just depends on the amounts that you're using. So if you're even in the two ranges, you can use this, but just a small amount. And if you go into the type four ranges, you can build this one up. It's an amazing basic leave-in conditioner to have, but if you're into wash and goes, heavy styling, then I would say first do a test into combining them on your hands. So the products that you wanna use, put it on your hands, mix that together, and just check out what the consistency is like. And then you'll know if it's suitable in combination with this leave-in or that you should cater to another one. Then we have the So Much Moisture Hydrating Lotion. I actually finished this one, or maybe there's like a teeny tiny bit left. This one is literally what it says. Whoops. It is like water. It is very, very lightweight, but intensely hydrating. I don't know if you can see it. I kind of feel like it is, if you think of skincare and you think of serums, this one resembles a serum the most. Like, for example, like a hyaluronic acid serum. This one is so easy to distribute. It gives a lot of slip and you instantly feel that moisture boost. I would say this one is as well for every hair type. I would say that if you're into the 3C ranges and then go to the 4 ranges, then you will need more to help make that moisture last, if it makes sense. So I would not use this as my only leave-in, but it is perfect if you need that moisture boost, especially with this season, to add before you apply your basic leave-in conditioner to give it that extra nourishment that it needs to last all week. Then we have the detangling conditioner, and this kind of looks weird when you see it. I know the first time that I got it, I was like, detangling conditioner, like, do I need to rinse it out? But it's actually a leave-in. It does what it says. It's a detangling leave-in. Personally, I like to detangle with my conditioner or my hair mask in, so I don't really use that as a step. But if you're into doing braiding or box braids or anything like that, this would be a good option after, for example, blow drying your hair or whatever to prep it, because it is really easy when it comes to styling afterwards. I feel like out of all of the leave-in conditioners, this one is the one that I wouldn't recommend that quickly. If I would recommend it, I would recommend it to people that have a lot of tangles, or to use it on kids to make like the process easier. So to right away have a leave-in conditioner, then detangle and start styling. The last one out of their basic range is the Moisture Milk. And this one is more richer. I would say out of all of the leave-in conditioners out there, main range, this is the richest one to get. So I would say for type 3, if you're in the type 3A, 3B, then I would say not to use too much because it does contain a lot of oils. And if you're in the type 4 range, you'll love this one. Let me just show you. This one is very rich. Very rich, very thick in consistency. And you do feel like the oils in it. I also like the scent of this one a little bit better. I do like the scent of this one and the, which one? And the leave-in conditioner. And it's just really a lot richer than the other ones. So if you're into that, if you really like a little bit of a richer leave-in conditioner, then I would use this one, the Moisture Milk. It does say that it's a daily hair revitalizer. Personally, I would not use this as a daily revitalizer because I would have way too much buildup. I would rather go for just spray or even like the So Much Moisture to add daily added moisture. I would not use this one on a daily. It is perfectly fine to use it once and it will keep your hair nourished all week. Then we have the other ranges that they came out with. And I think that the first one, at least in Europe, that they came out with was the Long & Luxe line. And they have one leave-in conditioner and it's called the Grow Yogurt. Now what the Grow Yogurt does in comparison to the other leave-in conditioners out of their main range is this one is really all about strengthening. This one is not based on coconut oil, but more based on aloe, so aloe vera. And this one contains multiple proteins and also ingredients like biotin, caffeine, niacinamide to really help the scalp, but also the hair. So this is great if you have damaged hair. So if you're suffering from damage or if you're lacking protein, then I would say go for this one. You can really define their lines into their needs. So the main range is all about nourishment and moisture. So it's more moisturizing, hydrating in that way. The Long & Luxe line is all about rebuilding, strengthening, if you get the idea behind it. What is also cool about this one contains a UV protector. So this one actually protects your hair against the sun. So that's a good thing to know. So again, if you're more into protein-based leave-in conditioners, then I would say definitely go for this one. The consistency of the Grow Yogurt. It's kind of a mixture of the leave-in and the Moisture Milk of the main range. It's a little bit more liquidy, so it's kind of, if they would marry, then you would get this consistency. By the way, there's one thing. You guys know how intense I am about fragrances. I'm just very sensitive. This one has the scent of pomegranate and passion fruit. This scent is intense. I get headaches with this one, unfortunately, but other people love it. So it really depends on how you are on scents. Even though I like to use this one every now and then, I tend to not grab it as often due to the scent. Then another line that I came out with is the Dry and Itchy. So with the Dry and Itchy, it's all about the scalp care. The whole range is built up on the biggest issue that a lot of naturals have, which is a dry and an itchy scalp. So they really paid attention to what that type of scalp and hair needs, and they came out with this range. Now this range is more so focused on olive oil, tea tree. The thing is, what I do have to say, that tea tree can cause more irritation. So if you notice that your skin isn't responding well to tea tree, then it will probably do the same on your scalp. It does have glycerin as the second ingredient, so it has a huge amount of humectants in it. Also aloe based, and it contains olive oil, it contains tea tree, it also contains peppermint. So all those kind of soothing ingredients that also help you not to think about the itching. I feel like using tea tree and peppermint also has a psychological effect into you not thinking about the itch, if that makes any sense. So I would say if you have more problems with flaking, with itchiness, again, like it already says, then go for the dry and itchy. And consistency wise, so it's a great thick leave-in conditioner. So there is one range, at least that is out in Europe, that I actually don't have, and that is the Jamaican Black Castor Oil one. So I'm just gonna check out which products they have and just give you my first thoughts on it. So I've never tried these ones out, but I'm just gonna look at it from an ingredient standpoint. And the Jamaican Black Castor Oil line is to restore and repair. So I feel like it's kind of a little bit similar to this one, even though like the Long and Luxe is mainly about like having length retention. It's protein based, so I'm kind of like, what will be the biggest difference? But let me just see. Well, the biggest difference obviously is that it is based on castor oil. So I see castor oil, linseed oil, and absorbic acid. Nothing too spectacular actually. And they have the Jamaican Black Castor Oil water. The Jamaican Black Castor Oil, from a ingredient point of view, has both repairing and moisturizing ingredients. And this one is, it, even though it does contain glycerin, it's more catered to scalp stimulation and protein. So I would say that is the biggest difference. The water, it will be kind of like this, but then Jamaican Black Castor Oil base, as far as I see ingredient wise, but those are all the leave-ins. So I would say most of them you can use on every hair type. It more so has to do with the texture preference, ingredient preference, and also the amount that you use, that you apply. I hope this kind of helped you out into deciding which one to get or which one to try out. If you have any other questions, or if you would like me to do this with another brand or another product in a hair care regimen, then please put it in the comments down below. Stay safe, and I hope to see you in the next video. Bye.